Did you know that 85% of Facebook users watch videos with the sound turned off on their device? That's why captions are so important to add on your videos. So I'm going to show you my favorite app for creating automatic captions. Hey there, welcome to the video. I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys. Now, if you're into video production or if you just want to make better videos, consider subscribing to the channel because that's what we're all about. Now, as I said in the intro, the numbers don't lie. 85% of Facebook users watch videos with the sound turned off. And the same can be said for Instagram too. So it's really, really important to add these captions to your videos. And not only will it help smash your engagement rate, but you'll actually help people with hearing issues as well. So it's a really important thing to add to your videos. Now, if you've tried adding titles to your videos as captions before in programs like Final Cut, iMovie, or Adobe Premiere, you know it can be really time consuming. It's really hard to get the timing just right. So I'm going to show you a little app called Mix Captions, which actually takes your videos, you import it, and then it will automatically create the captions for you with ease. So let's jump into it and I'll show you exactly how it works. Okay, so this is the app. It's called Mix Captions and you can get it on the App Store. I've already downloaded it. It is a free app to download, but you do pay for your minutes. But there are some free minutes included with the app, so it's definitely worth checking out. So first of all you need to do is press New Project here. Now we've got two videos here that we've created today. This one is an Instagram story size and this one is a 16:9. So I'm gonna show you how to do it on the Instagram stories. Because as mentioned, an Instagram story or a Facebook video is usually watched with the sound turned off. So if you were to play this through without any sound on, you of course would not hear what I was saying and people may miss the message that you're trying to put out. So essentially you want to start by selecting your start and your end point. So if you have a 10-minute video and then maybe just a 1-minute section that you want subtitles for, maybe that's the only bit of speaking you've got in the video, you would select that here. We're going to do the entire thing as we've cut this down to 20 seconds. We're gonna hit use, and then it allows you again to just have this section here. This is kind of like the in and out points, and then we're gonna hit captions. Now, what you need to do is select your native language, and this will help the auto detection process of your captions. You then wanna click generate captions. This will show you how many credits you're using, and you can buy credits with it in the app. This is 21 seconds of captions. So all I'm going to do now is click the generate captions option. Now, what you can see at the bottom here, it's saying preparing audio. Now, what it's doing, it's reading that audio, it's sending it back to their servers. And this transcription process usually takes around 30 seconds to 1 minute, depending on the length of the video you're using. So we'll let it do its thing and come back to it once it's done. Okay, so it's already done that quickly. So as you can see here, it's added the captions automatically. Now, if I play that through, we can hear what it sounds like and see if it's accurate.
So there we go. That's how you can add some brand new fonts into your favorite programs on your iPad. I really hope that helped you. And if it did, please give this video a thumbs up and leave me a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. And I promise I do get back to every single comment. So thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe and I'll see you.
So there we go. You can see that was actually perfectly accurate. There wasn't really anything in there I'd change. Maybe I'd add a comma or a full stop in there. But essentially, that was perfect. But let's just say it did make a mistake. You'll find that sometimes it will. It'll get the odd word wrong. All you'd need to do, you can actually edit these. So let's just say we want to change the first line. You would tick into the first line and then you can come in here and you can edit that text. So you can capitalize stuff, you can remove words, you can change words if they're wrong. But I just love how easy that was. That was super fast. Imagine how long this would take if you were manually doing this in Premiere, Final Cut or iMovie. So once that's done, you tick the OK. You can then change the style here in the bottom corner as well. So you can see we've got this kind of standard style, and that's the style that I would usually go for. But you do have the option here of different kind of fonts. So you can choose fonts that maybe go particularly well with your brand. You can also do the size as well. So if you feel like it's kind of something that people aren't really gonna need, but you'd like them there, you can make them smaller. If you really want people to see your message, go for a nice big bold font. You've also got the options down here to change the fill color, so we can make it a blue color if we want to. I'm gonna keep ours on white. You can also add a stroke or you can change the background color. So Editor's Keys colors are kind of like an orange. in our branding, so we could make the background an orangey color and it may fit in with our brand a little nicer. I tend to keep it on the default because I think it's what people are used to, and a nice sort of black on white font. It makes it easy to read and it's not too intrusive. So once you're done and you're happy with that, click done again, and then you can add a watermark here. If you have got the free version, you'll see there's a mixed captions watermark up here. We actually pay the $3.99 to remove that because we're gonna use this for all of our business videos and brand videos. All you then need to do, once you're happy, is click share, and then you can share directly to Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. What I tend to do is add it to my camera roll, and then I can add it to Instagram and add my tags and keywords as we go along. Now, let's say you prefer editing on your iPad. There's also an iPad version of the app too. It works exactly the same as the iPhone version, but of course you get a bigger screen. And if you're using an app like LumaFusion or iMovie, this fits in perfectly into any workflow. So there we go. You can now add captions to your videos with ease. So what did you think of that? Has that saved you a ton of time? If it did, please leave me a comment below because I promise I do get back to every single comment. So thanks for watching the video. And if you want to get more tips on mobile video production, check out the other videos in our playlists. So thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. So there we go. That's how you can add some brand new fonts into your favorite programs on your iPad. I really hope that helped you. And if it did, please give this video a thumbs up and leave me a comment below. I'd love to hear from you. And I promise I do get back to every single comment. So thanks for watching, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.